We good to go?
Hello, my name is Kara, and I'm going to start off today doing a little bit of a tutorial for everyone. And the main focus of this tutorial will be the Mika 3, because I got it recently and I haven't had too much time to play with it, so that'll be fun. So you always want to start with a clean face, and then the first step will be to prime. The primer I'm using today is the Porefessional by Benefit. So it really helps to reduce any pores or fine lines, anything. Our next step is to do foundation. So I'm doing Cover FX N10. It's our lightest neutral shade. And we're just going to use a little bit and just start in the center and blend it all around the face. Gives a nice natural coverage, nothing too heavy. And you really want to make sure you apply it evenly. You can use a brush or a sponge. I like to use my fingers. And then I'll go back over and blend it in with the brush as well. The brush I'm going to be using is the Sephora. It's their mineral powder brush number 45. So I'm just going to use that to blend in, make sure everything's nice and even, go around the edges. Now to conceal under the eyes, I'm going to use Maybelline. It's their Instant Age Rewind, their eraser for dark circles. So I'm patting that in. It has a nice little spongy tip to it. So I'm going to put that on and just dab it in with my fingers. So it gives a nice natural coverage, nothing too crazy. I don't really like anything too thick under my eyes. Now for other areas of my face, I do like to use something a little bit heavier. So I'm using Benefit's Erase Paste, just on different spots and blemishes, usually throughout my chin area, and a little bit more coverage. So I just tap that on right with my finger. Next, we want to set everything with a powder. So I just use the Revlon's Color Stay Powder in Fair. And I'll use that same mineral brush that I used before just to really pat it in. So instead of brushing it through, I'm kind of just tapping it right into the foundation. The next step is to use a bronzer. So I have the Physicians Formula. It's their light bronzer, the multicolored one. So this is one of my favorite matte bronzers just because it is harder to find bronzers in a lighter shade. So I'm just going to use this to sculpt out my cheekbones, just bring it down right from the top of my ear. And then just do a little bit all over just to give you a little bit more color. And you really want to make sure you're blending this too, because you don't want any darker streaks in your face. So now for blush, my favorite blush is actually by e.l.f. It's called Twinkle Pink and it has a really nice sparkle to it. Some people do say it's similar to NARS's their Super Orgasm just because it has that sparkle. I think this is a little bit more on the peach side, but it's really nice. This is my everyday blush. And I'm going back and blending that again with the mineral brush. I just like that to blend because it's a lot softer. And then for a highlight, it's the Sephora brand. They're Stardust. It's hard to see in the picture. But it has a really nice, almost like a golden color here. And the brush I'm using is a Sephora brush. I don't even know what it's for. It's a little bit flatter. And I just do a little bit of highlight on my nose and forehead as well as the cheekbones. Now we're moving on to brows, and I actually have one of them done already. We start with the Brow Wiz in Brunette. Now this one's nice because it does have a little spoolie on the end, so you definitely want to brush through your brows just to make sure all the hairs are in the right place. And then you start with the pencil and just outline the brows, kind of fill them in where they need to be. And I do extend mine a little bit farther.
Wanna know you better know you better know you better now. I just wanna know you know you know you.
You do want to brush through them a couple of times just to make sure they're a little soft and a little more natural. And then I'm going to go in with, this is an Ingold liner brush from Sephora with the NYC powder. And I got this a while ago. So it's just in brunette. And that just helps to fill them in a little bit more, make them darker. Because my brows are pretty light in comparison to my hair. Another one of my favorite products is the High Brow by Benefit. This one's really going to make your brows stand out more. So you just put a little bit underneath the arch of your brow and just blend that in really well. I'm using a contour brush by e.l.f. So it's a nice little brush and it really helps to blend it in. And then you just want to set your brows. This is the Anastasia, their clear brow gel. So that'll just keep them in place all day and waterproof them as well, which is always good. Now it's time for the eyes. So I'm using Urban Decay's their eyeshadow primer potion in their original. You just want to do a nice light layer on both eyes just to prime them. Helps keep the shadow in place. It's a really good step to use. And then we're going to start off with Makeup Forever's Aqua Shadow. It's in 2E, it's like a darker brown. So with that, we're just going to really define the crease because we're going with a little bit more dramatic look. So apply that, and then with that e.l.f. contour brush again, I'm going to go in and blend that out. And then I'm grabbing another Makeup Forever shadow liner. It's in 30E, it has a little bit of a shimmer, it's a nice light pinky beige color. We're going to do that one right on the lid and really blend that in as well. And it's going to act as a really nice base for our colors because some of the shades aren't as pigmented as I would like them to be. So for the first color, we're going to use the brush that comes with the palette, actually the thicker side. And I am using Limit. So that one's the fourth color in the palette. Nice light matte shade, and we're going to do that right on the lid. Next, I'm taking the brush that came with the Naked 2, so it has that nice blending brush, and I'm going in with Factory, so it's a darker shimmer. I'm going to place that right in the outer corner and the crease too, so pat that in and then really just sweep it along into the crease. Then with that same brush, we're going to do Blackheart. Now Blackheart's nice. It's a nice black shade with a lot of pink shimmer to it. It's really pretty. So we're going to go right on top of that other shade that we did, just make it a little bit darker. And then with that same brush, we're going to go in with Strange, which is the lightest shade in the palette, and use that right below the brow and just really blend out any of the dark edges around the eye. Now back to that first brush we used from the Naked 3 palette, and we're going to go in with Burnout, which is the third shade. It's a nice satin finish, a nice rose gold color to it. It's a little bit lighter, so we're going to bring that right on top of the lid, and then we're going to layer Dust, which is the second color. It's more of a shimmer, so that'll go right on top of that as well. You just want to clean up any fallout, any messiness you see. And we're going to stick with Urban Decay for the liner. This is Zero. It's a nice black liner. And it does go on really nice and creamy. I'm going to use this in my waterline first, just because we are going for a more dramatic look. And then I'm going to put it right on top, on the top lash line. I'm going a little bit thicker with the line. And then I'm going to extend it out just to give it a little bit of a wing as well. Now I'm going to go back in with Blackheart, so that's a dark shade, with an angled liner brush and just layer that on top just to give it a little bit more shimmer and to even it out too. You better know, you better know. you can see, my lashes are pretty light, so mascara is a definite must. I always switch up my mascaras. Right now I use Buxom Lash Mascara in the Blackest Black, so that'll be my first step. So do a little bit on the bottom too, really fill them in, and then I go back in with Benefits They're Real. So that just gives them more length and more definition too. So I really do like to use two of them together. And sometimes when I am going a little bit more dramatic, I like to use a white liner in the bottom waterline. It just makes the eyes pop a lot more. So this one is the Sephora, their Flashy Liner Waterproof. The eyes are done, it's time for lips. Now you can use whatever lip balm you want. I just like this one because it matched my shirt today. And then we're gonna go in with a light pink lipstick. This is the Revlon. It's the matte number 2 pink pout. This is one of my favorite, like, lighter pinks. It just gives a little bit of a color. And then we're gonna go in with a Stila Kitten Gloss. So it has a nice gold shimmer to it. So it's nice and subtle for the lips. I don't wanna go too crazy with these eyes today. And that's it, you are done. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully I'll have some more videos soon. And if you have any comments, feedback, I'd love to hear it. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.